like to explain the physics of the floating cork in the drop tower. These surprising results that the cork sank into the water, moved downward, and stopped can be explained easily. When the cork is floating, it has always weight downward, and as it is in equilibrium, it is balanced by a buoyant force acting upward. This buoyant force is created by the weight of the water that is not present because the cork is there. Now at drop, weight would become zero, so some students might believe that the buoyant force would remain, and therefore the cork might be shot out of the water. However, on drop, the weight of the water that isn't there would also be zero, so the buoyant force becomes zero as well, producing no apparent force acting on the ball at all, which might lead some of your students to propose that the ball would just sit there in the water unchanged throughout the drop. However, when all these major forces go to zero, surface tension is still present, represented by the meniscus that surrounds the ball. From the drawing, you will note that the meniscus goes up the ball, meaning that the ball is pulling up on the water and the water is pulling down on the ball. This downward surface tension force acting on the ball creates a net downward force which does work on the ball as it moves downward. This positive work that is done on the ball gives the ball kinetic energy, and it continues to increase its velocity and kinetic energy until the ball is completely submerged. When the ball is completely submerged, there is no meniscus and no net force, meaning that the work then at that point is zero, but the ball has momentum and kinetic energy, and it is moving downward. As it continues to move downward, drag from the viscosity of the fluid produces negative work, which removes the kinetic energy from the ball until the ball stops with no kinetic energy and remains motionless throughout the remainder of the drop.